Hey YouTubians, what's up? I'm another XYZ, and welcome back to another Club Banger. Today we're hanging out in r/anti-MLM. It's that subreddit that just keeps on giving, so we're gonna go ahead and hop right on in. I started this business 5 months ago, as I didn't want to be tied down by a 9-to-5 job, working on somebody else's terms. I now earn a full-time income through my phone, spending each day doing what I love. I'm so grateful that I'm able to help others do the same. Let me know if you would be interested in hearing more about it. No thank you, myself being a nurse, I know all I need to know and don't need to be taking fake vitamin tablets or whatever else you ladies promote. But thanks anyway. That's so hilarious. We have so many nurses in this business and don't even sell vitamin tablets. We mix science and botanically based ingredients that have actually changed people's lives. So yes, I will continue to share these. Goodbye, honey. If the last message this person sent was true, that they have nurses in her business, big yikes from me. It always bums me out, and I don't know if this is just a me thing, anytime I hear that there are nurses or teachers involved in these, because I feel like, I don't know, man, it's just a major yikes to me because I have a lot of respect for teachers and nurses. So when I hear they get caught up in stuff like this, it just really bums me out. I saw you online looking for a Love Winks consultant. You asked for recommendations, and among all of the comments, you liked mine. You liked mine. You appreciate my talent, my craft. Shortly after you messaged me, you went and liked my page. We exchanged messages about what you need for the bedroom, and I sent you my pricing. We even discussed options for your spa products and essential oils. You didn't reply. You ghosted me. You will be back. You need somebody dedicated and professional. Someone who genuinely cares about their clients. You need me. I'll be filling your home with all good things. We will work together. I just know it. Yo, I am getting some creepy stalker vibes off of this one. The reason they ghosted you is because they were probably just trying to be nice to you about stuff. They got in too deep and had to find an out, and that out was completely ignoring you. It sucks, but sometimes it happens. On top of that, maybe you should probably see somebody about this because it seems to me that you might be pretty close to doing some dangerous things, and I do not like that at all. Direct salespeople, aren't we annoying? Nope. You get annoyed with direct sales because of the stigma surrounding the idea, because you have been told that they're all part of a grand pyramid scheme. You are annoyed because they are living, breathing products of the product, and they aren't afraid to tell the world. So let's just drop the stereotypes for a second and get real, okay? Pyramid schemes are illegal, and direct sale teams are nothing like them. Do your own research. A direct salesperson is amazing to me. Do you realize how much hard work it takes to be successful? These are people who believe and want something and make it happen. They don't quit. They get told no. They get told no a lot. But do they stop? Of course not. Because no one is going to tell them no to their dreams. Direct sales offers something that an 8-to-5 job doesn't. Limitless potential. Not to mention incredible support of their team sponsors. So to all you beach body makers, thrivers, makeup sellers, independent consultants, etc. Keep getting it. You're inspirational. And your work tails off doing what you do. I support you. And I'm going to be honest here. I completely support the idea of doing your own research. It's just that all the research is going to tell you that these things, even though most of the time they're legal, rarely ever pay anyone a living wage. And a lot of the times these companies don't take into account the amount of money you have to spend to even get to the point where you're making money. So costs aren't included in that a lot of the time. Just look at the income disclosure statements. They always speak for themselves. It's not gonna work. Why don't you get a real job? You'll never make money doing that. It's one of those things. You aren't good enough. Only special people can do that. Only lucky people make money at that. Hope you have a backup plan. Why can't you be like your brother, sister, friend? They went to school. You need to work for a big company. It's a pyramid. You have to be practical. prove them wrong. Unfortunately, statistically speaking, you're unlikely to prove them wrong. Just like I said in the commentary in the previous post, check those income disclosure statements. They will tell you everything you need to know. It's unlikely that you will ever make your money back in these things. And if you do, it's because you are either lucky or you are charismatic enough to swindle other people out of their money. My face, when people tell me that Arbonne is a scheme, I just want to break something down for y'all. Pyramid schemes are illegal. What an actual pyramid scheme involves is absolutely no product exchange for money, and people who invest early on are the only ones who make a profit when others give money for nothing in return. Arbonne, on the other hand, sends out product daily to people all over the world. We do not make money when people sign up. We only make money when product is sold, just like every sales company out there. The difference is, there's room for everyone at the top, not just one person. It's just wild to me that so many people are more comfortable and willing to work hard for one guy at the top than themselves. That one guy at the top, newsflash, makes a percentage of all the work in sales all of the employees do, and 90% of the people below them never get the chance to be at the top. That sounds more like a pyramid scheme to me. In Arbonne, you have the same chance as me and everyone else to get to the top. There is room for everyone if you're willing to work there. I wish people wouldn't run from opportunities that look different than what they're used to. A little education on what this is and hard work can change your life completely. Start investing more in yourself than someone at the top in corporate America you'll never get the chance to be. Take the risk, sis. The view is better from up here. I just looked it up to be 100%. The argument that really irritates me with a lot of these are these people that say, like, there's room at the top and you get to be the leader of your business, etc., etc. Arbonne has a CEO, and they make a ridiculous amount of money. So you never actually get to be the CEO either. They just give you the illusion that you're a business owner and that you're running things and that you own your own business and you are at the top of said business. And it's just not true. The work that you're doing pays the CEO at the top of Arbonne. So at the end of the day, it's the same thing. If you had the opportunity to start earning 5 checks a month just by using social media, why wouldn't you do it? I don't have the extra money right now. Okay, cool, and you never will because your bills will be due every month and you won't have extra until you get your 25-cent raise in 6 months. Be real with yourself. Don't wait until you are going through trials and tribulations to ask for God to show you the way. That's like starting a project before reading the instructions. Feel free to message me opportunity. We are booming right now, and you don't want to miss out. Nah, dog, I'm good. I would rather not message you. When people give Huns the excuse, I don't have the extra money right now, it's just a way to get you off of their back. If somebody sends you that, they're just trying to be nice and kind of give you a soft leave me alone, as opposed to actually being straight up about it. Moral of the story, though, is just to stop pestering people with your opportunities that cost money. Just ridiculous. Oh no, I got sucked into a scam that has paid me every month for the last 63 months. Even though our company is featured in Forbes magazine and have celebrities who've partnered with us, I should have listened to all those haters in the mom groups. Maybe if I did, I'd still be working 40 hours a week to be broke. Maybe if I did, I would have never met all the amazing people I have. Oh well, can't win them all. Hashtag don't listen to the people who aren't where you want to be. And you definitely don't want to be in an MLM, so don't talk to this lady. This next post is by the user CityCherry2244. The title of the post is, Ruthless Hun at Grocery Store Had Me Thinking I Was a Trafficking Target. I mainly need a place to vent after what just happened. I'm in my late 20s, small female. I stopped at the grocery store after work. It's 8 p.m. Dark. I'm exhausted from 12 hours of work. I'm trying to get in, get out so I can get home. I'm going about my shopping and hear someone say, OMG, I love your pants. I turn around to see a woman about my size, wearing scrubs, smiling, and I reply, oh, thanks, I got them at Athleta. And I turn around to keep shopping. Even though my back is now turned to her, she will not stop talking to me. She's going on and on about my pants. I'm giving her one-word answers, and I'm getting really sketchy vibes. I genuinely thought she was trying to distract me so someone could come steal my purse or kidnap me for trafficking or something. I'm really not the kind of person who lives their life thinking all the bad things that could happen to me, but her behavior was so bizarre that something just felt really off. I started looking around to make sure no one was approaching me from behind, etc. You can probably guess where this is going, but of course, she starts asking me where I work, and asking if I work full-time. Mind you, this whole time I'm having my back turned and am giving her one-word answers over my shoulder. Very leave-me-alone body language without being a complete and blatant bitch. I'm in the Midwest. It's in our blood to have to try to keep some level of politeness, even though I shouldn't have. She then goes on to say, yeah, I work part-time now as a nurse. I'm so blessed because my husband and I have some friends that have this awesome side gig. They're on track to retire by 35. Teach me your ways, right? Blah, blah, blah. Obviously, I knew when she started asking about my work that it was some MLM crap. I basically ended up walking away, and she legit yelled down the aisle, "Well, have a great night," and waving like a maniac. What grinds my gears is like, who the hell are you to pester me at the grocery store to the point where I'm genuinely questioning my safety for a moment? Like, get the fuck out of here. The fact that they have literally no shame and target people is disgusting. They are such predators, and I can't believe their companies promote that type of behavior. I know none of this is new or groundbreaking, but damn. Thankfully, I am able to handle myself. But I think of someone like my poor grandmother in that situation. It's so sad and disgusting. Thanks for letting me vent. Fuck MLMs forever and always. And Huns. Fuck the Huns. Yeah, so if somebody has their back turned to you and is giving you one-word responses, just stop. Nothing you do will help you in that situation. Get out of there. But not Huns. They stick around and try as hard as they can to keep that conversation going in hopes that you will join their downline. Has anyone ever had a situation like this one in real life where you go somewhere and you are trying to be as curt and short with them as humanly possible and they continue to try to pitch the MLM to you? Let me know in the comment section down below. And thank you for joining me in r/anti-MLM. Drop suggestions for any subreddits in the comment section down below. Also, if you liked the video, remember to hit that thumbs up button. If you didn't like it, the other button works as well. Remember to hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of my videos. And like I say at the end of most of my videos, no glove, no love. Peace. Thank you.